Hello and welcome to another chess openings video. Today we're going over the Karo Khan and all the different variations you will go over as a beginner playing the Karo Khan. We're going to go over four main variations today: the classical variation, the advanced variation, the Karpov variation, and then a basic fantasy variation to go over to round you out. I'm going to give you the best tips for these four variations so that you have the best chance when fighting with the Karo Khan. Let's just jump into it. So to start off with the Karo Khan, if it starts, white has to go e4 and you go c6. If they don't go e4, it's not a Karo Khan, go with a different opening. So after they go e4, you go c6. They will usually take more in the center at d4, and we are going to push up with d5, fighting for control of that center, wanting to trade off these pawns so that we get the bigger center. Since they don't take, they're going to come out with the knight, which is a very standard move for white against the Karo Khan. We will take on e4, they take with the knight, and then to open up the classical variation, we go over here, bishop to c5. From here, white has a myriad of different options, but what they usually go with is going knight to g3, attacking this bishop, causing us to retreat over here to g6. And this is the most basic classical line for this variation. And from here, the best thing for white to do is to push up to h4, trying to trap this bishop in. We then push up to h6, creating an escape square for that bishop. When they do push up, we retreat that bishop back. And in this variation, what you want to do is you want to trade off this bishop for a light squared bishop. So what will happen is, say, white goes bishop to d3, we'll trade off there. From here on out, you go e6, closing this up and finishing your development. White will then push up over here to d2. We just continue developing our knight. They castle long and we're looking to castle short. From here, the game can go off in a myriad of different ways. But when you're playing the classical variation, the one thing that you want to do is make sure you protect that bishop and trade off the light squares. From there on, you just play a solid chess opening and you should be fine. So the next variation that we're going to be looking over is the advanced variation. And this is the one that's going to be most common that you'll be finding when playing the Karo Khan, just because people don't like trading those pawn structures and giving up the center. So what the advanced variation looks like is, after getting into our Karo Khan position, they just push up forward to e5. And what we'll want to do is develop our bishop over here to c5 before we close up this pawn position here. The main things that you're looking at when playing the advanced variation is we're attacking both these two pawns. So we can either do that by pushing up to c5 or pushing up to f6. But the main course of action is pushing up over here to c5 to attack this pawn and taking control of the center from there. Now, there are other ways of attacking this, and that is just go directly here. Because if they take, you can still develop out, but these two pawns are an island and it's going to be a lot harder for white to defend. As we push up and attack with the bishop or attack with the knight here so that this pawn can no longer advance, and while also attacking this pawn here. But for theory's sake, we go back to where we were. We go to the advance. We bring our bishop over here to f5. And in the Tao variation, which is probably the one I saw the most when playing the advanced variation, they kick the pawn out here looking to attack this bishop here. So what we want to do to face this threat is we want to push over here to h6. Now, the most important part of this position is if they push over here to g5, we do not want to push up to e4 here, which the engine says is best, because if we do that, we have a nice little pawn sack here. And after you take the pawn, this development stops. This bishop's kind of trapped, and we're looking at a lot of problems for us as black. Every time that I did see this pawn sack when I played against the Tao variation, I lost the game. So it's very important that you don't push your bishop here. What you want to do instead is, when they push up here, bring it back here, because if they do the pawn sack, you're completely fine. So again, from here on out, let's say they don't do that. Let's say they continue to develop like normal. Bring up the bishop here. We're going to close up our position. They bring up this knight here. We can push up here trying to force this. We have a nice little bishop trade. Most of the time, white will not take this. What you want to do then is, after, say, let's the bishop coming here, really fortifying this, you can bring the knight, bring another attacker. And when the time is right, you can push up here and attack the center. Things start to fall apart for white. So these are the main things that you need to do when playing against white in the advanced variation, is making sure you attack that pawn center with c5 or f6. You do that and wait for the right moment to strike when it's makes the most sense for you. You're going to win a lot of games against the advanced variation. Now, my favorite line of the Karo Khan is the Karpov variation. Now, it's one of the better Karo Khan openings, at least for me, because of the way I play. It gets me in the best positions that I can do to win the game. So that starts off with the usual Karo Khan position. And when they bring the knight out here on c3, we can just take and exchange the pawns. Now, from here, what we're doing is going over here to knight to d7, or in the future, we're going to go d6. And then if we get a knight exchange, we trade off the knights and we're in a better position. Now, what will usually happen is white will bring out the other knight and we just develop our knights. And when we trade off, we're already doing better. If white brings out its bishop here, it's important that we bring out our bishop before we close up this line, Right now, at this point in the variation, the weakest square we have is this F7 square. So it's best that we protect it as much as possible. So the next move, we will want to be pushing up to E6. If white castles, we bring it up. We're looking to develop our bishop and try to castle ourselves. That's a very basic Karpov variation, but there's so many different lines that you have in the Karpov. But the most important thing is getting this knight over here to D7, looking to go F6 and attack from there. So one of the things that you'll likely see when playing the Karpov variation is this bishop over here to C4. What we'll want to do is, because this knight's here and that bishop's already out, there's not a way to get this bishop out. So what we're going to do is just bring out the knight, trap the bishop in for the meantime, and continue developing. If they're going here, they're looking for this fried liver kind of attack looking thing over here. We're going to push up this pawn, looking in the next move to start pushing the knight back. So if they bring the queen here, we're going to swing the knight over here, attacking the bishop. They will retreat the bishop back, and then we push the knight back. And then we attack the pawn in the center. And when that happens, we just take the pawn. And with that, we've opened up the center for ourselves, and we've taken the lead developmentally while looking to castle and continue developing the white squared bishop. Now, back in this position, if white brings out this queen here, the number one thing that we don't want to do as black is bring up our bishop over here to E7. The reason being, you can see in the engine already, we're losing big. After the knight takes there, if the king takes, queen strikes, putting the king in check, fortify this bishop, and it's mate in one if the king comes back here or here, and it's mate in two if they go over here to g6, because after the bishop throws check here, the only place left for the king is there, and white goes to h3 for the checkmate. So make sure that when you are in this position, do not go bishop to e7, look to attack that bishop or attack that knight. Now, one thing to know about the Karpov is there is a line when the bishop goes over here to d3. When this happens, the queen is no longer attacking this bishop, so it's best for us to start attacking that pawn. Now, there's many lines where they can take, we could take. We want to do that now because it gives us control of the center as quick as possible. Let's say in this line we take, they take, we attack, and we can retreat back, we can castle the king. We're in a much better position because white's center is completely blown out. And there's a lot more ways for us to develop as black and win the game later on. Now, the last variation I want to go over is the fantasy variation, and it is really good for white against the Karo Khan. I'm not going to go super deep into it because there's a lot of theory behind it, but what it does is it gives white the big center that they want against the Karo Khan. So we push up on our usual. And the way the fantasy variations, they go to d5, counteracting what we're trying to do here in the middle. The worst thing for black to do is to take right there, because now white has a two pawn big center. We've lost our center pawn. We're not doing too well. If we push up and try to take more, the knight can come out, and we want to pin that knight to the queen right away. But white's just getting a fast developmental lead, and we don't really have much to show for it. We have to bring in more pieces to defend. And even then, it's white's solidifying its center more and more. And there's not a lot for us to do in this variation other than to get our pieces developed and our king castle right away. Because white's in a really good spot from here on out. It says here they're up half a point, and that's if you play the theory completely right. When I play against the fantasy variation as black, I usually have a hard time recovering and taking the center for my own. So that's it for the Karo Khan. I hope these tips help you when you're first starting out with the Karo Khan. The variations that I recommend the most to play as black against the Karo Khan would be the Karpov variation, and hope you get to play the advanced variation. I think the advanced variation is the most likely that you'll see, and one that you're going to win the most against. So if you like that video, please like and subscribe. You can also follow me at Twitch at twitch.tv/ZachSagowski, where I stream these openings and play with viewers and practice what I learn for these openings against viewers, and then instill all that knowledge into a nice little YouTube video that I have here for you. In my next video, I'm going to be going over the Smith-Mora gambit. It is the only thing I play as white against the Sicilian, so it's good to know the theory behind it and how I can best maximize the gambit against black. That video will be here. I'll see you next time, and you have a great rest of your day. Bye.